Day three. We're about to hit up Dumbo, ride the bikes on Brooklyn Bridge, and hit up this city. Go, 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 get it, what? Hey, 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 hey. Super sick. Yeah, my thighs are dying.
And it's cold.
Becca's a trooper. She's going for it. Feels good. Mark feels good.
We're on the down slope now. Let's do it.
Alright. Let's do.
We walked our bikes across Brooklyn Bridge.
Yeah, we did.
Brooklyn! That's how we do it in Brooklyn. We walk our bikes.
Kidney walk.
You're a tourist if you ride your bike.
Well, that was a long walk for me. Jeez.
Thank you, Kidney Foundation.
Thank you, we
can rent bikes later again. There's the building right there. Last time, my sister and I, we came here with our family back in 2000 in the summer. And we actually got to see the Twin Towers before the tragedy that happened on 9/11. So it's pretty crazy being here and seeing all this and all the names all across, everyone who had passed away from the event. And just want to say, man, what a great country we live in, so resilient. Man, we're so blessed. Check. Does it bring back any memories?
I'm trying to remember when we went. I do remember going up.
I do.
Yeah.
I remember seeing both towers.
Yeah, so it's so crazy.
It's crazy, absolutely crazy.
Kind of emotional.
Shit. Thank you.
sudden, everything above us broke.
I was thrown onto my desk. Shelves came down. Pictures came off the wall.
There was an immediate explosion. A number of the elevators, doors had been blown off. Fire was coming up through the shaft. Marble and ceiling and floor had come up or fallen over.
That stairwell literally shook from side to side. The concrete was breaking there. The steps were like waves in the ocean, undulating underneath our feet.
People on the stairs started to fall.
And I just froze and I started screaming like I've never screamed in my life. The brain shuts down and your body goes into motion.
Hey guys, so we are here at the 9/11 Memorial Museum, and you know, I'll just be honest with you, I didn't realize how emotional it would get me. I knew it was, it would take me back, and it definitely took me back to when I was fifth grade in 2001, and all those emotions coming back, and you know, being in Hawaii, being the last ones to find out, and turning on the TV to see all these, you know, the Twin Towers hit, the Pentagon hit, United 93 crashing in the ground. It's just very hard to describe, you know, how it's like being in here. You know, if you're ever in New York, I really encourage you to come here to the 9/11 Memorial Museum and learn your history, or be reminded of what America really went through. Back in 2001, I was in fifth grade, so I know, you know, anyone younger than me, you know, it's very, you know, difficult to take and make it personal, because you just don't have good memory. But I really have a clear memory of what happened and how I felt that day. But just being here really just, you know, really reminds you and opens up your eyes of how impactful 9/11 was. I mean, I still remember airports and how they were before this whole thing happened, and now there's all these extra security, you know, of course, to keep us safe. And I'm leaving this place so appreciative of all the first responders, you know, not just here in New York, but all across the state and this country, you know, the firefighters, the police officers, you know, all the medics, and just everyone, all the first responders, just very thankful. And being here just reminds me to be thankful, and just very emotional here. You know, we got to hear a lot of like actual people calling from the planes that were hijacked, to call back their loved ones, and them leaving voicemails, and people leaving voicemails for firefighters who passed away on that day. And it's just very, they've done a very good job at all the details and really hitting the fields. And you know, I just want to say I'm proud of being American and very proud of these New Yorkers and America who are resilient and didn't let this day break us. But just want to say God bless everyone who serves, and all the first responders who are serving this country and serving each other. And just, man, just take this time to pray, you know, for your family and those who are in the military. Take time to pray for those who, you know, are first responders, and pray for your loved ones, because, my goodness, it's just a great reminder to be thankful. So, all right. Question on one thing that hit you at the World Trade Center.
Everything, but mainly there is pictures of people jumping out.
What hit you?
The atmosphere.
Atmosphere, yeah, for sure.
And just seeing everything that was there.
The actual, like, tangible things.
And hearing voicemails and just hearing people's
yes.
Yes.
That's the voicemails.
I actually feel it.
Okay, things that hit you.
Well, there's a lot.
Yeah.
So, probably the one that hit me the most was the one where the woman is like leaving a message on the plane, and she sounds super calm, and at the very end starts getting really choked up and saying, "I really hope I see you again. I love you."
Yeah.
And I was just like, but and like, there's a lot of like stuff.
And they were just kind of trying to downplay it, yeah, just to not.
She was like trying to stay really calm, but then she gets super choked up at the end.
Ooh, I think that hit it. How about you, Mark? What hit you?
Voicemails.
falling man picture.
Oh my gosh, yeah. Seriously going to bike the Brooklyn Bridge again. So, actually just walking our bikes across where I am for now, because I'm so tired. So is Justine and Chanel back there with Mark Abad. I'm freaking walking this thing. Got Mark here with me. Such a good friend. Biking. While I'm walking, I bet he would pack me too if he could. Okay, we're like one third there.
There you
are. Here we are, Molly. There's a big Brooklyn Bridge for ya. Let's go, boys. Oh, thank God. They sent the ambulance for me. I'm right here. Take me to the hospital. They see us rolling. They hating. Yeah, we just finished biking the Brooklyn Bridge. I probably walked half of it and rode half of it. It's okay, the end was worth it, I gotta say. That downhill, that coasting was fun.
Guys, it was awesome.
I got some sick footage.
That was awesome.
Gee.